Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Excel In-Depth, Chapter 32, Expanding Charts. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Talking about charts in Chapter 32, here's one of my favorite tricks. So I used to have to create a dozen charts at the company I worked for every month. And so it would be the first of the month that I had to go back and recreate all the charts. It just took me the whole day to do it. If I would have known this next trick, life would have been so much simpler. Here I have a chart with data for January through March, and I have a new data point, April. So I'm going to choose the heading and the data. Really important that you choose the heading, and we're going to copy, so that's Ctrl+C. And then I click on the chart, and I press Ctrl+V. Ctrl+V, it takes my existing chart, adds the new data to the right-hand side. I like the copy and paste method, because it works even if the chart is on a different worksheet than the data. You can copy and paste. Now, if your data and chart do happen to be in the same spot, first click on the chart. Look at that blue outline right there. That blue outline shows the data that's in the chart. To add new data to the right-hand side, grab that blue outline, drag to the right, and the new data gets added. Those blue outlines are pretty cool, actually. You can use it to take data off the left side, or even to change which data is charted. So if I wanted to show just sales, there's just sales, or just profit. Do all that using those blue outlines. So pretty cool method there. The new method, is using tables in Excel. So we press choose our data, make sure to have a heading up there in A1, press Ctrl+T, and we define that as a table. So now the chart is based on the table, and then when we add a new month, it will automatically become part of the data, or part of the chart. So a very interesting way to go there. Ctrl+T to show the convert the data to a table, and any charts and pivot tables that are based on that pivot table will automatically grow. Alright, so don't create your charts time after time after time. Just use last month's chart, put the new data next to the old data, and then use one of these three methods to get that new data to your chart. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.